beautiful and eminently civilized music, isn't it? Jean-Philippe Rameau, The Arts and the Hours. And before that, the piece, The Cyclops, in which young Mr. Olofsson demonstrates such digital dexterity and daring do. The old timers would say, man, he's just gone a heckin'. It's incredibly fast. And all those repeated notes, he plays so cleanly. All right, let's calm down a little. We'll return to two more pieces from Debussy, one of his most charming pieces, The Girl with the Flaxen Hair. And then from the Preludes, Book Two, we'll hear Ondine. The two great French Impressionist composers, Debussy and Ravel, were so good at water scenes. And there we have Debussy making a piece on the water nymph Ondine, which Ravel also did. Rather big, splashy piece, rather kind of a scary piece from Gaspard de la Nuit. In the case of Debussy, he's basing his picture of Ondine on some illustrations of a man named Arthur Rackham, who's famous for making pictures for James Barry's Peter Pan, a copy of which had been given to Debussy's daughter. That's how he came to know of Arthur Rackham. So Debussy's Ondine is a little bit calmer than that of Ravel, because Debussy's portrait was inspired by a rather gentle English gentleman, Arthur Rackham. We have time for just one more piece from Vikingur's remarkable album bringing together Debussy and Rameau. This, for me, is the most gentle and beautiful playing on the entire album, the Musette en rondo.
Thank you.
I find that piece really affecting. In a funny way, it recalls for me music from the future. I don't know if that's the right way to put it. I could imagine that with strings coming from Michel Legrand, from a Hollywood film. The French are brilliant at portraying a sort of noble sadness in their music. That was Rameau's Musette en Rondeau. So that performance brings us to the end of the first hour of The Treasure Hunt. This kind of meandering through my great big inbox and finding these wonderful pieces. That was Víkingur Ólafsson's recording of Debussy and Rameau side by side. And we are going to bring back young Mr. Ólafsson later in the week to hear some Bach from him, as well as a little bit of Brahms. There's something else to look forward to. Thanks for joining us today. I'll see you tomorrow. Exploring Music is produced by Cindy Gillard at WFMT in Chicago and produced and engineered by Bill Sigmund at WQXR in New York City. Our production assistant is Eric Opland. Major support is provided by the Paul M. Angel Family Foundation, the Earl and Brenda Shapiro Foundation, Helen Sell, Mr. and Mrs. William G. Brown, Eugene Jarvis and Sasha Gerritsen, and the listener supporters of WFMT. I'm Bill McLaughlin, and thanks for listening. This is the WFMT Radio Network.
It's our pleasure to bring you exciting music and bright ideas each week on Exploring Music. But without the support of your local radio station, this programming would never reach you. If you enjoy the insight that Bill provides, then we encourage you to support your local radio station and let them know what Exploring Music means to you. As always, you can learn more about our program at exploringmusic.org. And this is the WFMT Radio Network.
Exploring Music is presented by Calora Piano.
With Roybke's dramatic sonata, transcriptions from Wagner and Liszt, and new pieces by Henry Martin, Nathan Lauba revels in the power of the University of Minnesota's vintage Aeolian Skinner pipe organ. You can savor the sounds as Nathan inaugurates Northrop this week on Pipe Dreams from American Public Media. I'm Michael Barone. I hope you'll be listening.
Presented by the Dallas chapter of the American Guild of Organists, Sunday night at 10 on Classical 101.1 WRR. Classical 101.1 WRR, FM and HD1, Dallas-Fort Worth. Classical music and the arts for North Texas. Monday Night at the Symphony is presented by Metroplex Piano on Classical 101.1 WRR.
Even in these difficult and trying times, we occasionally discover those precious silver linings, like the Piano Now Silver Lining Sales Event at Metroplex Piano. During your stay at home, this is the perfect time to experience the joy of this magnificent instrument. Whether the kids are just learning or you're rekindling your relationship with the piano, you will find unprecedented incentives to make this the perfect time to reach out to Metroplex Piano. These offers include immediate, massive stimulus rebates up to 50% off, 24 months 0% financing, and 90 days deferred payment offers are also available. Learn how you can also receive free, sanitized, white glove delivery and even private piano lessons. Make the best of your time at home with the Piano Now Silver Lining Sales Event, only at Metroplex Piano. Shop virtually or in a sanitized private appointment at metroplexpiano.com.
There is nothing quite like the experience of a live concert by the Dallas Winds, America's greatest wind band. The visceral thrill as they fill the legendary Meyerson Symphony Center with their Grammy-nominated mastery just can't be matched. Of course, right now, like so many venues, the Meyerson sounds more like this. But before too long, it will sound like this again. Haha, that's the stuff. But to get through this unscheduled hiatus until the time we can take our rightful place on the stage again, the Dallas Winds needs your help. So please donate to the Can't Beat the Band Fund at dallaswinds.org. Whether it's piccolo-sized or tuba-sized, every donation makes a difference and will help sustain the band until our live concerts can once again blow the Meyerson's roof off. Life is better with the band, and life in Dallas is definitely better with the Dallas Winds. So donate today at dallaswinds.org. We thank you, and we can't wait to play for you again.
Good evening. I'm Barry Samsula, and you're listening to Monday Night at the Symphony on Classical 101.1 WRR. Tonight's program features the Dallas Winds and is presented by Metroplex Piano. Since 1985, the Dallas Winds has shared the joy of band music with millions of listeners across the globe. Known internationally for their 22 groundbreaking recordings, the Dallas Winds has earned 5 Grammy nominations. In addition to their Meyerson Concert Series, the Dallas Winds is active in music education, providing performances and instruction for over 20,000 students annually through concerts, clinics, camps, and more. The Dallas Winds partnership with Dallas ISD has helped DISD increase band enrollment by over 40%. This Dallas Winds concert was recorded on September 16, 2016 in the Meyerson Symphony Center and features cymbalom soloist Lawrence Kapton. For complete program notes, go to the Dallas Winds Facebook page at facebook.com/DallasWinds or the website at dallaswinds.org. G.G. Cheryl Norwood, Director of Operations for the Dallas Winds, has more on tonight's concert.
Thank you, Barry, and good evening, everyone. The 2012 Summer Olympic Games had barely come to a close in London when the Dallas Winds performed tonight's concert at the Meyerson Symphony Center. Kicking off with John Williams' lavish Olympic fanfare and theme, the concert turns more somber with W. Francis McBeth's Kaddish. Program notes for this performance are available at dallaswinds.org. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Maestro Jerry Junkin and the Dallas Winds.
Thank you. This next piece is a very special piece in our repertoire. As your program note tells you, we are dedicating this performance to the memory of the founding conductor of the Dallas Wind Symphony, Howard Dunn, who so many of you knew. Howard was for so many years a fixture in the Dallas area because he had taught both at Lake Highlands High School, at Richardson High School, later in Dallas at Skyline High School. He was the fine arts supervisor for a period of time for the DISD, and also, of course, was the wind ensemble conductor at SMU. And in his spare time, he helped Kim Campbell found the Dallas Wind Symphony, and he was quite a remarkable man. Howard, when he was at Richardson High School, commissioned one of the great bandsmen of all time, W. Francis McBeth, to write a piece for the Richardson High School band. And it was this piece that you're getting ready to hear, Kaddish. So tonight, unfortunately, we must tell you that we lost W. Francis McBeth this last summer. He was a wonderful contributor to the wind band medium, and of course, every time we play a concert in this beautiful hall, we remember Howard Dunn. So we thought it would be only fitting to remember both of these fine gentlemen with the piece written by Francis McBeth for Howard Dunn, Kaddish.
Thank you. Thank you.
The Dallas Winds want you to know they're still here, and they have every intention of returning to live performances as soon as possible. In the meantime, find out more information about Summer Serenades live streams, the musicians, and more at dallaswinds.org. The next Dallas Winds broadcast on WRR is September 28th at 8 p.m. Join the Dallas Winds for Come Sunday by Omar Thomas and a guest appearance by New York Philharmonic principal trombonist Joe Alessi. The Dallas Winds is supported in part by the City of Dallas Office of Arts and Culture, Dallas Tourism Improvement District, Texas Commission on the Arts, the NAM Foundation, TACA, Classical 101.1 WRR, and by generous listeners like you.
In musical notation, there's this thing called a fermata. Now, that's just a fancy Italian word for a hold or a pause. Well, the Dallas Winds, America's greatest wind band, is kind of on an unscheduled and unwelcome fermata right now. Call it a fermata non grata. And we get it because the safety of our musicians and our audience is absolutely paramount. But like all fermatas, or is it fermati, this one is just temporary. The music will come roaring back, better and stronger than ever. Yep, just like that. But to get through this hiatus until the time we can make beautiful music together again, we need your help. So please donate to the Can't Beat the Band Fund at dallaswinds.org. Like every note in a symphony, every dollar makes a difference and will help sustain the band until our live concerts can return in all their brassy brilliance. Life is better with the band, and life in Dallas is definitely better with the Dallas Winds. Donate today at dallaswinds.org. We thank you, and we can't wait to play for you again.
Classical 101.1 WRR, FM and HD1, Dallas-Fort Worth. Classical music and the arts for North Texas.
In musical notation, there's this thing called a fermata. Now, that's a fancy Italian word for a hold or a pause. Well, the Dallas Winds, America's greatest wind band, is kind of on an unscheduled and unwelcome fermata right now. Call it a fermata non grata. And we get it, because the safety of our musicians and our audience is absolutely paramount. But like all fermatas, this one is just temporary. The music will come roaring back, better and stronger than ever. Yep, just like that. But to get through this hiatus until the time we can take our rightful place on the stage again, we need your help. Please support the Dallas Winds on North Texas Giving Day this Thursday, September 17th, from 6 a.m. to midnight. Whether it's piccolo-sized or tuba-sized, every donation makes a difference and will help sustain the band until our live concerts can return. Life is better with the band, and life in Dallas is definitely better with the Dallas Winds. Make your gift this Thursday at northtexasgivingday.org. We thank you, and we can't wait to play for you again.
You're listening to Monday Night at the Symphony on Classical 101.1 WRR. Tonight's performance, The Dallas Winds.
Welcome back to the second half of our concert. Ottorino Respighi was one of the last great European composers of the Romantic Nationalist tradition. Like his contemporaries, Ralph Vaughan Williams, Percy Grainger, and Zoltán Kodály, Respighi drew on the musical traditions of his native land in writing such beloved tone poem cycles as The Pines of Rome and The Fountains of Rome. With the lesser-known cycle, Church Windows, Respighi recalled the many hymns and chants of the Italian Catholic tradition to create a composition that sparkles as brightly as stained glass in the sunlight. And now, once again, please welcome Maestro Jerry Junkin and the Dallas Winds.
From time to time, someone will say to us, gosh, you know, there's this wonderful organ in the Meyerson and nobody ever uses it. People even write such things in the newspaper on occasion. But I will say, if you come to Dallas Wind Symphony concerts regularly, you know that we use this organ every chance we get, especially because we love working with Mary Preston. And so she's with us tonight. So if you don't know this piece, just trust me, you are going to hear the Lay family organ in all of its glory. And when we get to that last movement, you know what, if you want to turn your cell phones on, that's fine, because you're not going to hear them, I'll just tell you. It's not going to bother anyone.
Thank you.
It's like you're expecting something else. We thought that since this was the first concert of the season, and for those of you who are always with us, you know that we usually end each concert with a march by John Philip Sousa. We thought that since tonight, first concert of the season, it's only right to play the greatest of all the Sousa marches. So this is the Stars and Stripes Forever.
Next Dallas Wings broadcast on WRR is September 28th at 8 p.m. Join the Dallas Wings for Come Sunday by Omar Thomas and a guest appearance by New York Philharmonic principal trombonist Joe Alessi. Information about the Dallas Wings and their musicians can be found at dallaswings.org. Follow them on YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram. The Dallas Wings is supported in part by City of Dallas Office of Arts and Culture, Dallas Tourism Improvement District, Texas Commission on the Arts, the NAM Foundation, TACA, Classical 101.1 WRR, and by generous listeners like you. I'm Barry Samsula. You're listening to The Dallas Winds on Monday Night at the Symphony, presented by Metroplex Piano on Classical 101.1 WRR.
Monday Night at the Symphony is presented by Metroplex Piano on Classical 101.1 WRR.
With Roipka's dramatic sonata, transcriptions from Wagner and Liszt, and new pieces by Henry Martin, Nathan Lauba revels in the power of the University of Minnesota's vintage Aeolian Skinner pipe organ. You can savor the sounds as...